God, I am Betty, and today we are talking about praying with confidence. The word of God in the book of Hebrews chapter 4 verse 16 says, let us approach the throne of God, the throne of mercy, to seek mercy, to seek grace, and all the help that we need. So friends, the Lord expects us to approach Him, to come to Him with all confidence. Not only for mercy, not only for grace, not only for help, but for everything that we need in life. Whether it is your health, whether it is victory, it is success, it is breakthroughs, it is relationships, whatever you're looking for, you can get it when you approach the throne of God. And what other better way to approach the throne of God other than through prayer? And some of us, it may be hard for us to approach the throne of God. And you're wondering, how do I get close to this God? It was hard for me also, until I got to discover the God that I was praying to. There are many things I got to know about this God, but there are three things that helped me to build my confidence in coming to my God, knowing that I can come to Him anytime, from any place, and receive the mercy and grace and everything that I need to go through life. The first thing was the knowledge that God is my Father. Being my Father means that He takes care of everything concerning me, and that's what He says in His word. That do not worry about food or clothes or anything else, because your Father knows that you need that. It is His responsibility to take care of all your needs. And that's why He says, ask and you receive. If you, bad as you are, know how to sort out good things for the people you love, and especially your children, how much more will the Father in heaven give good things to His people? God is our Father. Sometimes we are scared to approach His throne because of the life that we are living. Maybe we are living in sin. Maybe we are carrying a lot of guilt. Maybe we are carrying a lot of shame. Maybe we see ourselves in mess, in a big mess, and we are wondering, how do we get up? How do we even raise our eyes to the Father? But we have to learn from the prodigal son. The prodigal son knew his father in spite of the life he was living. Even when he was tired of the life he was living, the encouragement he got in his heart, what helped him to rise up, was the fact that he knew that his father was loving. And that's why he said, no, I must rise up. I must return to my father. I will confess, I will repent. But deep in his heart, he knew that his father was loving. He was a father. He had not abandoned him. He had not rejected him. The Father expects you to approach Him with that attitude, knowing that He's loving. Will you approach Him today? The other attribute that helped me in my prayer was knowing that my God is generous. God is generous. He is always giving and giving, not only what we ask of Him, but there are so many things that we have, so many good experiences we have gone through, so many beautiful people we have met that we had never asked the Lord. But in His goodness, He has given all that to us because He is generous. He is not like some parents we know. I know of a father who is only generous when he is drunk. Our God is generous all the time. Whatever we ask of Him, St. Paul says, unto Him who is able to do or to give us exceedingly, abundantly, much more than we can ever ask or even dream or even imagine. So meaning, whatever we ask of the Father, He gives us much more. When His people, His children, were coming from Egypt to the promised land, and He was providing the manna, He was not measuring for everyone. He was giving abundantly, and He only told them, pick what you need and leave the rest. When we look at the story of the wedding at Cana, the word of God says that the wedding was coming to an end, but the wine had gotten finished, and the organizers were wondering what to do. And when they approached the Lord gives much more than they needed. Not only the quality, but so much that people were surprised. And everyone was wondering, who does that? Who keeps wine up to this time? Even the groom was able to notice that something has changed in the celebration. There was life coming up. So when the father blesses, when he gives generously. Consider the story of King Hezekiah. He was on his deathbed, about to die, and he was praying to the Lord to grant him some more days. The Lord did not just give him more hours, he did not just give him days or months, but he gave him 15 more years. So when the Lord gives us, he gives generously. So when you're asking of him, do not be scared. Approach him with confidence, knowing that he will give you much more than you can ever ask. And the last attribute that helped me about my God is to know that this God we are talking about is the creator, is the owner, is the master, is the controller of everything. Everything bows down at him. He created everything, seen and unseen, big and small. Our God owns everything. He can command the sea to create a way for you. He can command the wind to be still so that his children can cross over to the side they have to cross over. He asks us to ask of him because we are his children. That's why he says that you can ask for anything. Ask of me and I'll give you even the nations as your inheritance. I'll give you the whole world. There is nothing I cannot give you. Even if it does not exist, even if you have not heard about what you're asking about or asking for, know that your God is the creator. He can create it for you. And whatever we need from the Father, we can get. The only password is Jesus. Because the word of God says, all the promises of God to us through Christ Jesus are amen and yes. So if we want to receive everything that we want from our God, we need to go through Jesus. We need to have our trust in Jesus. We need to give our lives to Jesus as our Lord and Savior. And what does Jesus tell us? He tells us, ask for anything in my name and I'll give it to you. So the confidence we have as we are asking is knowing that the Lord Jesus, when we have him, we can have everything that we want. I love the statement that Jesus makes and it surprises me. He tells his disciples when he's going to heaven, I'm going to the Father, so you ask for anything. And he says, up till now, you haven't asked for anything. And that surprises me. That gives me more confidence that the Father is saying that up till now, no matter how many things I have asked of the Father, for all the 40 years that I have lived, Jesus is saying, up till now, I haven't even started asking. Friend, the Lord is telling you the same. You haven't seen anything. You haven't asked for anything. The Father still has a lot in store for us. There is so much he can give us. The joy, the peace, the blessings, the breakthroughs that we need. It's my prayer and I pray, Lord Jesus, draw close to us, hold our hands, and lead us confidently to the throne of grace, the throne of God, where we can receive everything that we need to go through this life. In Jesus' name, I have prayed. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.